Yet another all-time high for the S&P 500 as we close in on Thanksgiving. It's now up 12% for the year, even as the news from much of the rest of the world remains very bleak. So, how is this possible, and are we at risk from a bubble? Well, behavioural psychology suggests that bubbles are in large part due to overconfidence, and that in turn is driven by what's known as self-attribution bias. We tend to take credit for all the things that we happen to get right, and to blame others for the things that get wrong. And when I say we, it turns out that I should be talking for all men, because this is a problem specifically for men and not for women. That, at any rate, was the result of some fascinating research in 16 different countries conducted by Suzanne Duncan of State Street.
Men and women related to the self-attribution bias are nearly polar opposite, where men on average tend to take credit for themselves when they're successful and then they blame others for failure. Women don't take credit for when they're successful and then they blame themselves for when they fail. Similarly, overconfidence, men tend to suffer more from overconfidence bias and women suffer from an underconfidence issue.
If overconfidence is the biggest problem afflicting markets, and it's primarily a male problem, that implies that there should be a lot of women managing money. And the reality is,
when it comes to numbers, we found that it's on average for the traditional investment function to be around 10% are women in leadership positions within those organizations. And then the numbers get worse. So when you look at venture capital, private equity, real estate, hedge funds, only 3%. Represent women in leadership positions.
So, the cooler the head you need and the greater the risks you are taking, the more likely you are to come from the gender that is prone to overconfidence and to take too many risks. Great. What can we do about this?
So the key here is that we do need more diversification. The industry exists to diversify portfolios of assets, right? Imagine what we could do if we could actually apply the same diversification concepts in our industry.
Yes, even if you're a man, it's very hard to argue against that. Markets are terribly prone to crowd behavior. Hiring more women would probably do something to justify that. As it is, our male-dominated investment industry, egged on, yes, by our male-dominated financial media, has managed somehow or other to bring the S&P 500 to yet another all-time high this evening.